Hi, Dr. Ken here, and welcome back to Cool Science Tricks. On my YouTube channel, what I do is I look at the science behind magic tricks, circus stunts, and strange curiosities. Today, if you want to take part, all you need is a cup, and not one, not two, not three, but four dice. Yep, using these strange dice. Well, they're not strange dice, they're ordinary dice. We're gonna be doing a trick. Okay, this is the trick. You're going to take your dice, you're going to place them in a line like so, and then with your cup, I know what you're thinking. You're going, wait a minute, the inner scientist in me is going, that must be a camera trick. But I'm going to show you how it's done using a see-through cup. Let's see what happens in slow motion. If I take just one dice and do the trick, you'll notice it looks like the dice is actually levitating. It does so because of something called a centripetal force. And it's only there as long as the cup is moving. If I stop the cup, the dice falls because of gravity. Now I can actually replace the dice with water. Okay, that was a camera trick. But theoretically, this should work. At the moment, gravity is pulling it into the cup, and I'm gonna change the grip. And as long as I have enough motion, then you can see the water hasn't spilt anywhere. So let's have a look. Let's see if I can see if I can keep this going. Thank you, centripetal force. If you want to show centripetal force with water, there's a classic experiment with a string and a tray. When you start to swing it, like so, it's not a problem. But if it goes all the way round, it's still not a problem because of that centripetal force. In fact, you can make it go this way, and that centripetal force will keep the water in the cup. The only problem is stopping. I got away with it this time. Cheers. If you want to do this trick, start with just the one die. And then imagine that this is the motion you'll make with the cup. So just place the die in the cup and make that motion. And you'll get a feel for the force. You'll get a feel for how it moves in the cup. And if you stop applying the force, it will fall out. Then you've got to learn how to pick it up. When you first do it, as you push across, you'll push it from one side to the other, which means you've got to apply another force, which is a pull force. You'll pull it over and then catch it. So if I do it with a little bit more force, like so, you'll catch it in the cup like that. So that's the first thing to do. So you pull it across and up, and then it's in the cup. So pull it across and up, then it's in the cup. And then you can actually pull it across, it's in the cup, and then you're into that motion again. You've done one die, now you're ready for the second. And what I suggest you do is just place it directly on top, and then, again, go backwards and forwards. And you'll get a feel for the amount of force required to actually keep it in the air. Once you've got that, shouldn't take too long, drop them out. Place them on the ground, try and pick one up, keep it in the air, and then pick the other one up. And you'll notice you can just keep this going. Of course, stopping, so they're stacked up on top of each other, is gonna be really hard. So the first thing is just stop and see if they're on top of each other like so. And you're gonna try and have them like that on the table. Now that is a lot trickier. And the more you do it, the more you get the right amount of force so they're stacked one on top of the other. If you keep going backwards and forwards and just stop, they hit the side of the cup and then just roll over. So you've got to play with the forces as you put the cup down. What I tend to do is I try and give it a little turn, so as the dice come down, they move around the cup and then stop on top of each other. Well, that's the theory anyway. The same thing with three. Again, picking up three. The hardest thing with three is stop, see that they are again stacked up one on top of each other. We're up to the four stack. So you place one on top of each other, like so, and again, see what it feels like. This one is actually quite tricky, because when you pick them up, you've got to pick them up and then get them in that stack. Just like that. Voila. I prefer a solid cup. This is again a half pint cup, similar in size, similar in volume, similar in diameter as this cup here. Let's see if it works. Yeah, stacks just as easily. When I first saw this trick, I thought, wow, isn't that amazing? Is that a magic trick? Is it a skills trick? Does it matter about the size of the dice? Does it matter about the size of the cup? Well, I think you can agree, the experiments have shown it doesn't matter. The cup here is approximately the same size, slightly bigger. This is straight down here. These are angled. The diameter is completely different. This is flexible and a completely different material. You can do experiments with dice, different dice that you might have lying around, see if they work with any shape cup. That way you won't spend any money. But if you do want to spend some money, or you do want a set just like this, then I'll leave a link in the description. I hope you had fun exploring this die stacking trick, or perhaps you tried to spin a cup of water over your head. There will be more fun science appearing on my YouTube channel, so click and subscribe to make sure you find out the next time a new one appears. Have fun showing your friends, and remember, if you apply the same force, the same thing will happen. So practice, practice, and experiment. Until next time. Of a swing, so much so that it goes all, as you can see with the solid cup, made a pig's ear of that. The stacking is a little bit harder, as you can see I've only got one dice, and then with your cup